Welcome back to another Linux video. Today I want to show you my normal configuration, how I have configured my Linux system. I'm using i3 window manager and the configuration is really old. I think I've copied some parts of it from Manjaro, but I'm not sure. So it's really old configuration. So the background is from Pop OS, I think. We can look that up. I've got it. I think, yeah, it's Fractal Mountains by Kate Hazen. So this package is in one of the Git repositories of System76. You can just download them. Then I've got here also the Rofi themes collection. So I use Rofi here for as a run starter. I use Ranger as a file manager and Alacrity as a terminal, as you've seen right now. And what else do we have? I have key bindings here on the left side. That's because I always had the problem that sometimes someone else must work with my computer. And as I've changed some of the key bindings and also have some key bindings like Shift Mod F for Firefox, which make it easier to work with that, or I've got Shift Mod D so that I can directly jump into Ranger. And yeah, and also for Vim, as I'm Vim user, so so this is just an overview. If someone else uses the computer, then at least he can get or she can get a terminal open here, and from that it's no problem. Or as I always say, open Firefox, and most of the time that's sufficient for working. And if they need something else, then they have to use another computer. So normally on the Windows side, I'm quite used to work with Visual Studio Code, but that's just the work side because the colleagues, most of the colleagues use also Visual Studio Code. I've got the Win movements active, so there's a plugin in Visual Studio Code for that, but otherwise I'm using the same, so that we're on one base. And it's easier to talk and do things if you use the same tool. So but here on the notebook I'm using that, but I must also say, I've got a gaming PC for gaming, because most games in my opinion work on Linux today, but there are still some games I like to play that just behave better on Windows 10 or Windows 11. I don't have such a new computer. I still use Windows 10. It's quite old. And the other two desktops that I have here are Macs, an old iMac that I use for a long time now. And with OpenCore Patcher, I've have the newest macOS on that one. And that's how I work with the system. And perhaps I can now just show you around a little bit. So for example, or let's take Nano. What you do is you just install Arch with an Xorg installation or with a total basic installation, and then you install Xorg. And after you've tested that Xorg is starting, you just cut everything here at the bottom of the xinitrc. You must copy that one over, of course, into your home directory. And then you can just start E3 here. And as always, I don't use a login manager or something or a greeter. I just start with startx from the terminal. That's how I always have done it. And for me, it's the most convenient thing. The other thing that I fear are, let's see. Yeah, Pulse is, I use ISA mixer, I don't know what was, M perhaps, yes. So I've got ISA mixer here for the whole, Pulse audio configuration. Then the other things that I use are the two conkeys. So one conky configuration is, the thing on the left here that shows the hotkeys, and the other one here is this date and status that I've yeah, it's just some moving parts here, and I think it gives it a complex and nice touch. So if someone else looks on your screen, everybody says, oh my god, what's that? But it's I think the default configuration, I think, but I don't know. So it's the configuration here. You can just why can't he do that? Ah, okay. So I just have this two configurations, shortcuts for the left side and the conky comp for the right side, and he just uses that. And the other thing is the Ranger configuration. I've got quite some plugins installed for Ranger to view files, to view videos, to preview PDF, to preview EXIF pictures that are rotated by the metadata, what else? Yeah, all such things that you want to have in a file manager. And then what else? Yeah, the i3 config I can show you. So that's a little bit different than what we've done with Sway in the last videos. Perhaps if you've seen them on my channel, I showed how you can configure Sway on on Arch Linux. And so here it's a little bit different. The configuration files, I think there's a transition wiki entry in the Arch wiki where it's explained how you can transition from your i3 configuration to the Sway configuration. But here why do I have two times the font? Okay. I've just done some this here is a nice script, this i3 sensible terminal. There is a list of terminals that he goes through and tries to find one of the terminals, and the first one that has the highest priority in the list he takes. And so if you do mod return and have more than one terminal installed, the script will give him a terminal. I don't have more than one terminal installed. I've only got Alacrity on this system. So here I do with Alacrity the starts of the systems. Yeah, some time ago, but not on this system. I had Nautilus as the file browser. But if you install Nautilus, you get so much packages. And so at one point I switched over to Ranger. And Vim ISA mixer here is just started in the terminal by a shell, and so that you can start the terminal and do the start of the program in one step. Firefox is clear, I think, and then we can go here to the bottom of the script. Let's see if there's anything else. At the moment I'm not using a clipboard manager on my other system. I've got that, but Clipit is not available as far as I know in the extra repository, so I have to look into the hour to install that one time. But as it's just here, I've just copied over the system so that I can show you. I can't record on the notebook is the problem. So, NM applet is not available in Arch. So that are old configurations here from, I think, Fedora I used some time ago. And Faye I just use for the background picture. And what else? Config wizard is only the first time you start E3. When he notices that you don't have a configuration, he will try to start I3 config wizard and do the configuration for you. So that isn't really needed anymore when you have the configuration. And this year was a problem that I had with my my touchpad, I think. And then I start the two conkeys and that's all. And for autolog, I've got here I3 log. So after 15 minutes, he autologs and that's all. That's the whole configuration. I changed the colors a bit and so on, but as I said, I think that was a color scheme from an older Manjaro distribution that I copied because I liked the colors and how they've done this here with the white and the green and red for the interfaces that are down is quite nice. Yeah, so if you want to give an Xorg-based installation a try with Arch, that works also very great. And instead of using Sway, you just use I3 WM for that. And of course, when you want to have the same look as Sway, you can configure it with, I think it's one line you have to edit so that the bar is at the top. And but normally I3 is the default that it is on the bottom. So I kept it that way. Yeah, then thanks again for watching this just as a second bonus video in this how you can install a tiling window manager under Arch.